purple, yellow, and blue flowers. These flowers highlight our different reasons for being here today, our connection to the Alzheimer's disease. The orange flower represents people like Justin McDermott. Justin is here today because he supports the cause and the vision of a world without Alzheimer's disease. Justin says that at his job of touching hearts at home, he has a privilege of supporting clients and families who have felt the immediate impact of Alzheimer's disease. He sees incredible caregivers going above and beyond to support their loved ones. The compassion these families have motivates him to not only provide the best care possible to his clients, but also Alzheimer's Association in finding a cure for this heartbreaking disease. Now, if you have an orange flower, please join Justin in raising it and keeping it held high. The purple flower represents people like Leslie Cross. Leslie walks today for Elsa Marie Church, her mom, who lost her battle with Alzheimer's disease. Leslie describes her mother as an incredible force in her life. She tells us that no matter what disease overcomes your body and mind, you are still a person who deserves respect and love, and that her mother commanded that even up to her last breath. If you have a purple flower, please join Leslie in raising it and keeping it held high. The yellow flower represents people like Colleen Holland. Colleen walks today because she cares for people with Alzheimer's as part of her work at Loretto's The Nottingham. Colleen brings energy and spirit to enrich the lives of the elders she cares for and considers them her extended family. She is devoted to memory care development and is dedicated to fighting Alzheimer's. If you have a yellow flower, please join Colleen in raising it and keeping it held high. The blue flower represents people like Bertha Adams. You heard her story. She is here today because, as we just heard, she has Alzheimer's disease. Now, if you have a blue flower, please join Bertha in raising it and keeping it held high. A colorful display of our intent to honor, remember, care, and fight. We know we're facing a relentless and devastating disease that can't be yet prevented, cured, or even slowed down. But we also know that this is a fight that we can win. I am confident that one day we will add a flower to this garden, a white flower that represents the first survivor of Alzheimer's disease. Wouldn't this be just an amazing, beautiful addition to our garden?